Have you ever heard of an aircraft incident where the plane failed to stop while landing? This type of incident is called a runway overrun, which occurs when an aircraft exceeds the end of the runway because there is not enough space to stop safely. This situation is very dangerous as the aircraft could collide with obstacles, enter a body of water, or even crash into other vehicles around the airport, potentially resulting in fatal consequences. Therefore, the aviation industry continues to innovate to enhance safety, one of which is through the engineered material arresting system. In this video, we will take an in-depth look at how the EMAS system works, how this technology helps stop aircraft in emergency situations, and various real-life cases where EMAS has successfully saved lives. So, make sure to watch until the end. The engineered material arresting system, called EMAS, was first developed in the 1990s as a solution to prevent accidents caused by runway overruns, where aircraft fail to stop within the available runway length. Before the invention of EMAS, many airports faced space limitations that prevented them from extending their runways. Airports located near the sea, mountains, or densely populated areas often did not have enough land to lengthen their runways to improve safety. As a result, aircraft that failed to stop in time could go off the runway, collide with obstacles, enter bodies of water, or experience fatal accidents. In 1994, the Federal Aviation Administration began searching for a solution to this problem. They collaborated with Engineered Arresting Systems Corporation, a company that had previously developed emergency stopping systems for military aircraft. Research found that low-density aerated concrete could be used to create a stopping zone capable of absorbing the kinetic energy of an aircraft gradually without causing severe damage. In 1996, the first EMAS system was installed at John F. Kennedy Airport in New York, United States. Since then, EMAS has been adopted by various airports across the United States and other countries. Today, more than 100 runways worldwide have implemented this system, and it has been proven to save dozens of aircraft from serious accidents. This system has been shown to save many lives by safely stopping aircraft in emergencies. But how does EMAS work? Why is this system more effective than simply extending the runway? And most interestingly, why does the material used in EMAS have unique characteristics different from regular concrete? Runway overrun incidents may seem rare, but in reality, they occur quite frequently at airports around the world. According to data from the Flight Safety Foundation, approximately 10% of all commercial aviation accidents in the past 20 years have been caused by runway overruns. Some of these have been fatal, resulting in loss of life and significant aircraft damage. Although aviation is the safest mode of transportation, it does not mean there are no risks. Runway overrun is one of the incidents that can still occur. There are several main reasons why an aircraft might exceed the end of the runway. One major factor is extreme weather. Heavy rain, ice, or snow can make the runway slippery, reducing the friction needed for the aircraft to stop on time. Pilot errors can also contribute to the problem, such as delayed braking or miscalculating the available runway length. Additionally, technical failures, such as malfunctioning brakes or issues with the thrust reverser system, can make it difficult for an aircraft to slow down. Another factor is runway length, especially at airports in urban areas or near the sea, where space constraints prevent runway extensions. Because runway overruns are highly dangerous, aviation authorities like the Federal Aviation Administration and the International Civil Aviation Organization have developed various solutions to address this issue. One of the best innovations is the installation of EMAS at the end of runways. This system utilizes a special material that crumbles easily when compressed, slowing down an aircraft by absorbing kinetic energy as the wheels sink into the surface. With this technology, the aircraft can be stopped without causing severe damage to the fuselage or injuries to passengers. The material used in EMAS is not regular concrete, but rather aerated concrete that has a porous structure and can easily crumble under pressure from the aircraft wheels. As the aircraft enters the EMAS zone, this material breaks apart and creates significant resistance, slowing the plane down safely without causing a sudden impact. Interestingly, EMAS does not stop an aircraft abruptly, but gradually. The deeper the wheels sink into the EMAS material, the greater the resistance it creates. This way, the aircraft can stop in a much shorter distance compared to regular braking without causing dangerous jolts for passengers. EMAS is typically installed at the end of runways that lack sufficient space for extension. The system consists of multiple layers with a modular design, allowing it to be adjusted according to the size and type of aircraft that usually operate at that airport. The structure of EMAS consists of several key components: a protective surface layer that shields the material from extreme weather conditions, energy-absorbing material made of aerated concrete blocks or low-density foam designed to crumble under the weight of an aircraft's wheels, strategically placed support structures that help sustain the aircraft's weight and ensure the system functions optimally. After EMAS is used in an emergency, the damaged sections must be replaced with new modules to ensure it remains functional for future incidents. Since its introduction, EMAS has saved many aircraft from potentially fatal runway overrun accidents. For example, in 1999, a McDonnell Douglas MD-11 cargo aircraft failed to take off due to technical issues and entered the EMAS zone. Despite the aircraft moving at high speed, EMAS successfully brought it to a safe stop, preventing a major disaster. Thanks to this system, the aircraft was stopped without any fatalities or significant structural damage. Like any technology, EMAS has its advantages and disadvantages. One of its biggest benefits is its ability to stop an aircraft safely, even in difficult emergency situations. Additionally, EMAS does not require large additional space, making it ideal for airports with land constraints. The installation cost of EMAS is also lower than extending a runway. However, there are some drawbacks. One of them is the maintenance and replacement costs after the system is activated. Furthermore, EMAS is not effective for stopping aircraft traveling at extremely high speeds, meaning there are still limitations to its effectiveness. From everything we've discussed, it's clear that EMAS is an incredible innovation in the aviation industry. Thanks to this technology, many lives have been saved, and the risk of runway accidents has been significantly reduced. Although not all airports have adopted EMAS, it has proven to be highly effective in various emergency scenarios. What do you think about this technology? Should all airports implement EMAS? Share your thoughts in the comments.